Coming up next on Boston Rock Talk, former Bostonian Ellis Paul, a winner of multiple Boston Music Awards. Ellis is a veteran singer-songwriter who has carved out a deep fan base with his engaging and original songs. Hello, my name is Jim Sullivan, and welcome to Boston Rock Talk. This is a show where we will have musicians on set. We'll be interviewing them and probing their minds and then having them play some songs for us. And right now, we have Ellis Paul, a former Bostonian who has left our parts but is often back in our parts to play. Welcome, Ellis.
Thanks, Jim. Thanks for having me. It's good to be back in Boston.
Good to have you here. Ellis is a storyteller in song. Are you not?
I try to be. I think when I'm doing it at my best, that's what happens.
I want to ask you about perspective in the music that you do. Is it always you as the character singing, or are you singing outside of who you are?
Well, you know, I do a lot of character-driven songs that aren't supposed to be me, but it's tough to keep me out of the picture, you know. Like it's the same issue Van Gogh had when he was painting a cornfield. Everyone could see the cornfield, but the yellows were really bipolar against the black of the crows. And your personality comes through whatever you're siphoning through your creative, you know, mm-hmm. filters. So my life is going to be drenched in those people's voices as well as theirs.
Well, I think one of sometimes the problems with a lot of younger or modern singer-songwriters is it's all about them. And, you know, maybe it's the oversharing culture, I don't know. But you seem to like history, like knowing things and incorporating them into your songs.
Well, you know, when you're just starting out, you tend to filter through those first few songs that are about the immediacy of your life, your mm-hmm. girlfriends, your parents, your friends, the relationships in your peer level group, and after you burn those songs out, then you start going a little bit deeper, and then suddenly it's about your childhood and your experiences that you had then, or maybe it's about people outside that circle. And the longer you do it, the deeper you go, and then suddenly you have access to the entire world. And I think that's the good thing about being at it for 26 years. Like, I can write about my personal life. I don't often do it anymore. I don't focus on it unless mm-hmm. there's some therapeutic reason for it to pop out. But I like deconstructing the world and relationships and the things that I view as important, and trying not only figure them out for myself, but figure them out for people who are hearing the songs in a way that makes them maybe think or feel something that they didn't have access to on their own.
Are there times when you complete a song where you find that you have figured out something that's been puzzling you? In other words, the answer sort of comes through song?
Yeah, well, you know, it's not sometimes there's no real answer, no direct answer, but the questioning and the exploring is the important part, you know. It's hard to come up with a song with such a clear moral, and those songs tend to be really trite and about things people already know, but right. But it's just the thinking. I mean, how often do you think of a subject and then spend, you know, 20 days writing about it, you know? And that's what writing a song is. It's...
Well, shall we have you play one of the
sure.
new ones from
yeah.
the record? The record is Chasing Beauty. Just came out on September 1st. And what are you going to play from it?
This is the first cut on the record, and it's called Never Want to Lose You.
Go for it.
Thanks, Jim.